One of the common types of reactors is a semi-batch reactor, and here we'll briefly overview what that means and why it might be used. So typically it's going to be a liquid phase system, we're stirring, and then we're adding a second liquid. For example, there may be one reactant present in the liquid and a second reactant's being slowly added. Or it can be a liquid phase system where the product is a vapor and we're removing the product. Or it can be a liquid phase system where the second reactant is a gas. That's a hydrogenation reaction and we're adding and bubbling the gas through. So usually we're talking about liquid phase. It's not a steady state system and it is an open system where we're adding or removing material. And the question would be, why would we do this? What's the advantage? Why a semi-batch reactor? So there are a number of cases that justify using this type reactor. One might be where we want to increase selectivity. Namely, we have multiple reactions taking place simultaneously, and we want to increase the selectivity by preferentially increasing the rate of one of the reactions relative to the other. So, for example, let's suppose we have these two reactions. The rate that we form the product C is proportional to a rate constant and the concentration of A and B to the first power. The rate that we form the product D is another rate constant, and let's say it's second order in A and first order in B. If this is our desired product, desired reaction, then we like to keep the concentration of A low, since this reaction proportional concentration of A squared. If the concentration of A is low, we preferentially favor the first reaction. And so what that means to keep the concentration of A low is that we add A to a reactor that contains B. So this would be the case. We have the system here. We're adding A, and we start out with B in reactor. So A is reacting. A concentration stays low. We preferentially make the product C. So here's another type system where we have several reactions. A plus B goes to C. C reacts with D to make E. That's what we want to do. But B can also react with D to make an undesirable product. Then a semi-batch reactor, if we just add A and B, and we start out with a reactor containing just A and B, and we let it react to form C. So there's not much B left. And then we add D. So after most of B is reacted, we add D. It can react with C. It's not going to react very much with B because there's not much B left. Another case, semi-batch reactor, would be where reaction starts as soon as we add the reactants. You know, this is sort of, you might think of this as a titration type, where we titrate one of the reactants. Significant reason for a semi-batch reactor is heat transfer issues. If we want, for example, to prevent runaway, then we might have reactant or one of the reactants, say at 70 degrees where reaction is taking place, and we're adding second reactant at 20 degrees so that we can use some of the heat of reaction to heat up the feed from 20 degrees. So we can control the rate of reaction by adding a cold reactant. Another use of a semi-batch reactor would be where a byproduct comes out of solution, is removed, and for example, helps shift equilibrium if you can remove that from the system. Another case of a semi-batch reactor might be where one of the reactants is sparingly soluble. And so typical type reaction is some hydrogenation reaction, where the concentration of hydrogen that you can obtain in this liquid is low, and so you have to continuously add hydrogen to the system for the reaction to continue. Another application is where we have more than one phase reacting. So we have a gas flowing over, for example, a heated silicon wafer, and we're depositing, for example, boron from a boron-containing gas onto the surface, and then the byproducts leave. So we have a system where we're continuously adding material, and we would treat this as a semi-batch reactor. And then one more example would be where we want to, some reason we have to maintain the reactant concentration at a constant value by continuously adding the reactant so that we keep the rate close to a constant rate. We somehow are controlling the rate that we're adding the reactant to the reactor. If we look at the mole balance for a semi-batch reactor, so we're looking at just one component balance here where we're adding A. In general, we might be removing A. We have accumulation. The number of moles of A in the reactor any given time changes because A is being added. It's flow rate to some molar flow rate, moles per time. A is leaving, and there's some rate of reaction times volume. So for a given system, for example, this term might be zero, or this term might be zero. And now, of course, the volume is changing, so we may also end up writing a balance on volume that's related to the volumetric flow rate here coming into the reactor. Let's call that V0. And so a semi-batch reactor equation in this form looks the same as the startup of a CSTR. The difference is we may have both these flow rates for a semi-batch, but more likely we have just one or the other. So we have a number of reasons to use a semi-batch reactor, and we see the mass balance is fairly straightforward.